Hey, this is Xometry Greg, and I have a bunch of aluminum tiles in front of me. All these have been made with the same toolpath. All these are made out of 6061 T6 aluminum. The difference here is what finishes I chose, and this is a lightning round for surface finishes that I have, showing off these finishes and giving a brief example of how or why I may use one over the other. So right in the middle is as machined, so that's easy. When I just want a part to be machined out of aluminum, I maybe don't need an extreme environment, or I'm okay with just this as a prototype need. Let's just go with aluminum, get on with our day, and mill it right there. Now, if I want a conductive surface finish or a material preparation surface where I may do a secondary operation like powder coat or anodize, but I wanna have corrosion resistance, I may move to something like an erudite or chem film conversion. We have a clear and we have a gold available for this. So in this case, I'm showing the gold just because you get to see a little bit more here. Just note that that gold chem film, just like the clear, shows a little bit more cloudiness of the surface finish off going from milled to that chem film. Same's gonna go the other direction when I go to anodize. So anodize, I'm controlling this corrosion on the outside of the part by doing a dip bath and controlling an oxidized layer. So type two is just a little bit of oxidation on the outer side that is even and controlled. That creates corrosion resistance as well as turns this outer surface into an insulator so I don't have a conductive outer surface. That little bit of corrosion, I could actually pigment. So in this case, I have a blue anodized part. Very common to see reds, yellows, purples, and of course, black anodized with this. So blue anodized is great for that slight increase in durability. Again, making it non-conductive and also giving that lifetime corrosion resistance. So then we have a hard coat anodized. So this is black here. I'm gonna bring it a little bit closer. This is a type 3 hard coat. So unlike that type 2, like the blue there, this actually has a little bit of a growth to it as well. So maybe about a thou or so extra growth to it, giving it extra durability over time. So similar properties and needs for that type 2, only if your environment has high wear, high ruggedization, thanks defense, aerospace, military. Hey, my nickel plate's running away. Then we're going to be using the type 3 anodize. So talking about nickel plate here, let's go on the other side. I want a conductive outer surface, but I want something that's super ruggedized. Nickel plate is awesome. So this is actually a surface coating, if you will, of material that is not the base material. So I have an aluminum start. I'm actually going to put this in a bath. It's gonna attract nickel alloy to this. So now I have this very tough outer skin to the part. Notice it does have that nice increased shine to it. And nickel plating is great to maintain a conductive surface, but have lifetime wearability, so extremely durable. If you see a lot of parts that have mechanical features to them laying around, a lot of casted parts that may be made out of steel, which will corrode over time, oftentimes you'll see those nickel plated. So again, giving that lifetime use while using a more commoditized material. Another great option for finishing your parts. So we have a lot more surface finish availability at Xometry.com, but these are some of the highlights here. If you have any questions, let me know, ask a few, and I'll answer your comments. Thanks so much.